Power is something is a great tool to be deployed for many good things that can be done, irrespective of the area or the sector that we work in. It can be for social development, it can be for community development, it could be for children, women, education, health, whatever you call it. Power is a great tool to empower those around us. I would say coming back to India was a phenomenal decision, unbelievable for both of us. Unbelievable. I don't know what kind of courage and guts we had to do that. I told you, I think we're first generation entrepreneurs, and to deep dive into a subject like biotechnology and vaccinology and molecule development, it's unbelievably, I don't know. We were crazy. People thought that we were crazy too. So every day is a tough day. There's no such thing as I'm laid back tomorrow or I was laid back yesterday. Because every day as an entrepreneur, I think the mind is always buzzing with something or the other. There's always some problem out there or an issue that comes up, and then there's always problem solving, and there's always, sometimes there's firefighting. The pandemic is a great example of how we've been firefighting this entire 18 months in order to survive and do things. I think it is it's nothing is easy, nothing comes easy. It's the grit and determination to just look at challenges and convert them into opportunities. I think that is important. If I had to redo this myself, okay. Oh God. I would not change anything that I have done because I have been in this, my career spans, I think, about more than 35 years now. Ever since I moved to the US in 86, I would not change anything because hindsight is 2020. But yes, I would certainly want to give more time in order to learn. Maybe see how I could empower myself in terms of in areas where there are weaknesses, there are challenges at times. After all, we are all human. How I could self-development, because I come from a generation I did not have a computer in class, in school, or in college. So I learned everything the hard way from scratch. Maybe some of those tools that are available now, I could deploy and I could try and see if that would be of something that would benefit me as a person, as an individual, as a professional, as an entrepreneur. I've been the lone ranger in my board for a very long time. I don't know by it was not by design or default, but I guess it was destiny that I was there from day one. So I guess people have gotten used to me. We are a small board. We have people from the United States who sit on us. Some of them are our angel investors who have invested in the company. Who have seen the company from the first day, from the very first step onwards. What they see is what they get. Our board is a very kind of a soft board. I would not call it a difficult board because probably I'm the least qualified to be on that board. I mean, if I have to say it with due respect to all my board members, I'm probably the least qualified to be on that board. They are phenomenal individuals who have passion to be in medical sciences and to do something differently. So I speak less, but sometimes if whatever I do chair a couple of committees. So what has to be said or spoken is conveyed in a manner which is acceptable to everybody. And it's a very soft board. It's a very intellectual, academically driven and innovatively driven board as well. Otherwise, we would not be here 25 years as a company trying to develop new products and new vaccines and not being listed in the stock market. I don't know. I think I have probably not experienced it a lot. I don't know whether we are too soft-natured bosses. We are as much as we are leaders in our own, you know, in our own space and in our responsibilities that we have to be. But in the organization, Krishna and I are seen as employee number one and employee number two. That brings a lot of bonding and cohesiveness in the organization. The old timers, I can probably still rattle 100 names of all the old timers who have been with us. I don't see there has been a lot of dissent or disgruntled situations or scenarios. We try to address it. If there is anything that comes up and there are certain issues which are taken seriously as well, in terms of the sexual harassment and all the other acts that have to be, you know, that are statutory and also taken very seriously. I'm very tough when it comes to people who don't want to be disciplined or who don't want to be under the umbrella of the organization and what the organization has set forth for itself in terms of policy or the guidelines of the organization. I think that has to be respected. Even if it were me, I think I have to, I come under the umbrella of the organization. I think the organization's, it's important to ensure that it's fair and transparent. And it's also important to let people know that there are do's and there are don'ts. So people will understand. Initially, yes, we were small. It was difficult sometimes. But sitting, counseling with them, talking out with them, making them come together, discussing with them, not as a boss, but almost like a colleague or someone within their department on the same level of communication, not making them feel threatened, and making them open up. I always tell people, even if you say something wrong, express it and talk about it so we can find solutions or resolve things around it. So that is how I think we have taken, I have looked at things from day one. Very poor. Everything is deployed into Bharat Biotech. We have a notorious saying in the company that we have not paid dividends to our investors, except one who had to exit because of their fund was getting closed, and the ICICI. So they had to be, they had to leave because the time was bound and it was, you know, it had to be closed. But otherwise, all of us who have shares in the company have deployed our dividends back into the infrastructure, back into the new technology platforms that we have taken up, the innovation, the work of research, new innovation work that goes on. Working with universities abroad doesn't come cheap. A lot of, it's always like $500,000 or $1 million kind of agreements that have to be negotiated and deployed to have that kind of bandwidth of people and academic inputs and information to start working on projects. So investment is very bad, but everything has gone into expansion of facilities, be it Chiron Bearing was an acquisition. The Pune facility is also an acquisition by a sister company, group company. The Bangalore facilities again by group companies. So we have deployed some of our personal investment, not in other sectors or in the stock market, but in developing technology-based institutions, whether it is for agriculture or for animal biotechnology or for human biotechnology in different states in the country. I love music. I listen to a lot of music since childhood. It's a passion. I like cultural arts, performing arts. I like a lot of heritage. Traveling is something that I love to do. Of course, the last 18 months, it's a different story altogether. I also try to seek inner peace by turning inward and also trying to be sometimes trying to look at something that is beyond me in terms of understanding spirituality a little bit. And CSR is always in the back of my mind because I again grew up with that. I was part of the Scouts and the Guides movement right from my schooling and college days. So that probably that seed was sown somewhere there. So I engage myself with institutions that do a lot of community work, charity institutions like United Way of Hyderabad. I'm a board member. I was a founding board member and also chaired the board. So all these platforms which give me enough to unwind and also be away from the technology that I'm surrounded with all the time.